are called bryophytes. Okay, pteridophytes, which are considered as a true land plants. Okay, because it has a xylem and a phloem. Okay, that is a vascular tissues. Okay, it is a first true land plants. It has a vascular tissues, that is xylem and phloem. We know very well the xylem is used to conducting the water and minerals, and phloem is used to conduct the food materials. Okay, so we saw some of the examples of the pteridophytes: clepmoss, hostile, quillworts, water ferns, tree ferns. These are all belong to the pteridophytes, isn't it? Okay. So clepmoss picture already we studied. Just you have to see once again. So this is a structure of hostiles. Hostiles, that is look like a horse tail. So this is called the horse tail. Actual name is a eucysium. Okay, this is a eucysium. Quillworts, it's look like aloe vera. And water ferns. Okay, already I said this is a fertilizer which is used to increase the atmospheric nitrogen in the soil. And tree ferns. Okay, it's a pteridophyte. It's a vascular cryptogams. I said so. Vascular cryptogams means it's a xylem and phloem with non-flowering plants. So what is the name of the flowering plants? That is your phanerogams. Okay, and this is differentiated into root, stem, and leaf. Okay, so what about in the bryophytes? That is a root, stem, and leaf-like structure, but it has a root, stem, and leaf. So this is a sporophytic in conditions. Okay, sporophyte means it is a diploid. So in pteridophytes, sporophyte is a dominant phase. Gametophyte is a so it's a dependent phase. Okay. So what is the name of the gametophyte? The gametophyte name is, that's a prothallus, isn't it? So it has a monopodial dichotomous branching and microphyllous, macrophyllous based on size of the leaves. That is a microphyllous and macrophyllous. And stele is the protostele. Protostele means without pith. Okay. So in the center of the stem there is no pith. The xylem is surrounded by a phloem. Okay, that is called protostele. And siphonostele, it has a pith. Okay, the center of the stem has a pith. The next region is your xylem, that is surrounded by a phloem. That is example in the siphonostele is marsilia. Okay, so we saw the structure, that is in the sporangia. Okay, that is called by sporophyll. Okay, spore producing leaf is called sporophyll. It has a sporangia. So in the, we studied in the last classes how the sporangia liberator and which is undergoing the germination to form a new organ, that is called a prothallus. So from the prothallus we got it the sporophyte. Okay, the anthridium, archegonium are present in and under the prothallus. So during the fertilizations they have produced the sporophyte. Okay, so what is the medium is essential for the fertilization? That is a water. Water is essential for the fertilization. And tracheids. Tracheids are a part of the xylem. Okay, elements of the xylem. Okay, tracheids used to conducting the water. And another element is a vessel. Vessel is also conducting the water. The tracheids are major water conductant in the pteridophytes. But vessels are major conducting water element in the angiosperm. Angiosperm la water conduct panudu. Okay ma. Next is sporangia, that is a spore producing organ, that is a bag like structure. It consists of a spores. Then sporophyll. Okay, strobilus. What is the strobilus? Cone or strobilus. Okay, the spore producing organ are arranged one above the other. It's look like a cone like structure. So that is called the strobilus or cone. So example for that, there's a selaginella and eucysium. Selaginella, eucysium has a both, that is a spore producing organ are present. Okay, so this is a homosporous and heterosporous. Homosporous means it has a same type of spores. Heterosporous means it has a different type of spores are producing. The heterospory in origin, so that is actually the seed is originated from the that spore conditions. Okay, spore eppadi vandu keela vilandu mulachi varudho adhe maari da seeds ஓகேவா அப்ப ஸ்போர்ல இருந்து தான் இது வந்தது சீட்ஸ் அப்படினு ஒன்னு பிளான்ட்ல இருக்கு அதை எடுத்து நம்ம சோவிங் பண்ணா நமக்கு நியூ பிளான்ட் வரும் அப்படிங்கற ஒரு ஐடியாவே அந்த ஹெட்ரோஸ்போரஸ்ல இருந்து தான் நமக்கு ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணாங்க ஓகே நெக்ஸ்ட் இஸ் ஸ்போர் மதர் செல்ஸ் ஹியர் which one is a diploid which one is a haploid ஓகே ஸ்போர் producing மதர் செல்ஸ் ஆர் கால்ட் தட் இஸ் ஹியர் this region is called that is a 2N இது 2N when which is undergoing the meiosis which gives rise to the haploid okay adha dhaan already na sonne laddu mari irukkiradhu vandu ennadhu appadina adhu ennadhu microspore mother cell when it will be undergoing the reduction division which gives rise to the spores each spores are considered as a haploid idhu vandu diploid idhu vandu haploid the spore germinate to produce the haploid multicellular green chordate shape independent gametophyte is called prothallus idha yen independent solrona they have to germinate by themselves okayva so aduve germinate aagi produce panirudhu edha it is anthridium archegonium are produced then they have to complete their life cycle okay adula irundhu edhu vandu anoda life cycle start panudhu sporophyte okay appa short lived edhu appdin pathina inda prothallus dhaan vandu enadhu short lived okayva Next, how that is reproduced அப்படி பார்த்தோம் so through that fragmentations resting buds root tubers advanced buds okay through this way they have to reproduce that type of reproduction is called vegetative reproduction so sexual reproductions by oogamous okay oogamous means male and female sex organs are involved so that is a male sex organ is anthridium female sex organ is archegonium So male sex organ is produce the multiflagellate anthrozoites and female sex organ is produce the ovum okay the both of them is undergoing the fusion to form a zygote okay from the zygote the embryo will form okay that embryo is considered as a sporophyte again the sporophyte will produce the spores okay then the life cycle will be started So the what about the structure of archegonium? Archegonium consists of that is a ventral canal cell and neck canal cells. Okay, in the ventral canal cell is below. It consists of a ovum. Ovum irukka kudiya edam edhu appadina that is a ventral canal cell. Okay, so water is essential for the fertilization. Okay, as a result, diploid zygote is formed. Okay, the zygote is undergoing the mitotic division. So what about in the mother cells? It's a microspore mother cell is undergoing the meiosis division. Okay, so zygote is undergoing the mitotic division to increase the tissues and which is leading to the next generations. Okay, that increase ஆன உடனே நமக்கு என்ன ஆகுது? Embryo மாறுது. Embryo ல இருந்து sporophyte வந்து வருது. Okay வா? அப்ப mitotic எங்க நடக்கும்? Meiosis எங்க நடக்கும்? Okay. So pteridophyte shows apogamy apospory in conditions. So already I given that notes to you. So apogamy means that is a part of vegetative reproduction without fusions of male and female gametes okay va male female gametes fusion agama vandu or zygote form aachu appadina that is called apogamy that is a type of vegetative reproduction so apospory abingiradhu the megaspore mother cells okay from the megaspore mother cells abingiradhu that is a female gametes yeah so megaspore mother cell which gives rise to your so young generation that is considered as a apospory adha spore la irundhu or new plant vanduchuna adukku peru apospory okay va so any vegetative part la irundhu vanduchuna apogamy okay so that is we studied in the last class okay we studied the life cycle also so from the spores we got it the gametophyte so from the gametophyte we got it the archegonium anthridium okay then zygote is formed zygote is undergoing the mitotic division to form a sporophyte okay again the sporophyte gives rise to the spores okay this is a life cycle of pteridophytes next today we are going to learn about the classification of pteridophytes and that's the types of steels okay could you understand so who classified the that is a pteridophytes the pteridophytes are classified by the Rimer Propose a classifications for pteridophyte. In this classification, we have a five divisions. One is a Psilophytopsida, Psilotopsida, Lycopsida, Tenopsida, Theropsida. There are 19 orders and 48 families are there. Okay, just they given only the headings of the classifications. Each and every classes they have a different salient features. they have a different unique characters are there. Okay. So next, that is another classifications. This earliest classifications: Psilophyta, Lycophyta, Arthrophyta, Phylicophyta. Okay. So Psilo, from the classes, this is a division. This is a class. So from the division, Psilotopsida. Another one is Psilotum and Rhynia is example. Psilotum, Rhynia are example for Psilophyta. Lycopsida is a Lycopdinae. அப்படின்னு பேரு. இது வந்து Lycopodium is an example for Lycophyta. Phenopsida is a Eucisetum. Already I said hostile. Hostile means that is a Eucisetum. Okay. That is another name of Eucisetum is a hostile. That is Phenopsida, Eucisetum. Next is Chiropsida. That is a Phylicophyta. Okay. So there is a Phyllicinae. That is a name of the order Phyllicinae. The example for the species ferns. Okay, these are all the ferns. Okay, so next we have to see, that is your economic importance of pteridophytes. Okay, what are the uses? Enna uses la irukku paathona, first one Rumora adiantiformis. Okay, that is your Rumora adiantiformis. That is a leather leaf fern. Okay, leather la enga enga irukudo adukku mela mulachu varakudiyadhu. The cut flower arrangements. Okay, enna pannu adha nalla cut panni flora arrangement pannalam, ornament alum nama use pannikalam. The Marsilia, that is another species is Marsilia, which is used as a food. Azolla, that is a biofertilizers. Azolla is used to fix the atmospheric nitrogen in the soil, so which is cultivated in between the paddy. Okay, Dryopteris felix moss, that is a Dryopteris felix moss treatment for tapeworm. Tapeworm problem irundhuchuna adukku nama use pannikalam. So Teres vitata, Teres vitata. Okay, removal of heavy metals from the soil bioremediations. What is a bioremediations? We have to remove the chemicals from the soil. Soil irukkakoodiya chemical alla nama remove pananum appadina nama enna use pannalam andha edathila Teres vitata apdinga species ah vandu nama enna pannikalam anga vandu allow pananum adu cultivate pandradhukku adu valaradhukku nama allow pannom appadina so adula irukkakoodiya andha metals ella enna aagum reduce aagum okay adoda effects ella reduce aagum. So that is a bioremediations. For bioremediation process we can use the Teres vitata. Okay, next is Pteridium species. Okay, leaves yield green dye. Nama dye ella use pandranga green yellow dye ella andha dye edukkuradhukku idu use aagudhu Pteridium species. So Eucisetum species, stems for scoring. Scoring na nama vandu rubbing ku use pannakoodiyadhu, even skin rub pandradhukku use pannuvom illaina vandu wall rub pandradhukku use pannakoodiya material, that is produced from the, it is a Eucisetum species. It is very rough, the material should be rough. Then Psilotum, Lycopodium, Selaginella, Angiopteris, Aratia. So these are all used as a ornamental plants. Okay, so all the species we have to, well, we have to pronounce at least 10 times. Okay, then only it will be easy to us. Okay, so now your names are very difficult to pronounce, but after a week definitely I will call you each and every one, isn't it? It will be easy. So the practice is very very important for that. It's a Rumora adiantiformis, Marsilia, then Azolla, Dryopteris felix moss, Teres vitata, Pteridium species and Eucisetum species, Psilotum and Lycopodium, Selaginella, Angiopteris and Maratia. So these are all the species used for ornamental plants. Okay, which one is used for the, that is a biofertilizer, that is a Azolla. So which one is used for tapeworm treatment? That is a Dryopteris felix moss. Okay, so which species is gives green dye? That is a Pteridium species. Okay, the used for a scoring, that is a Eucisetum species. Okay, so each and every one is converted as a one mark. Okay, so next we have to go types of steels. Okay, so what is a steel? Already I said steel means, that is your the center regions of the stem. Okay, there's a PVP, I said there's a pericycle, vascular bundle and a pith. Okay, so pericycle is the outermost layer of the vascular bundle and inside we can see that, that is your xylem and phloem, then pith is in the center. okay. So that is your PVP. It is divided into three. They are pre-grangana, first protostele, then siphonostele, dictyostele, eustele. Okay, wow. So here, so what are the types of protostele? There is a haplostele, actinostele, plectostele, mixed protostele, polysteles. These are all the type of protostele. So actually in the protostele, in the pith is surrounded by, actually pith is absent here. The xylem is surrounded by a phloem. Okay. What about in the siphonostele? The pith is present. Okay. So what about in the dictyostele here? The pith is absent. You will see the next slide. It is easy to you. So this is a detail of types of stele. Okay. Listen carefully. The protostele, siphonostele, solenostele. So what is the difference between the three steles? Enna difference nu paathona? Stele without pith. Okay. Enga pith illa protostele, there is no pith. Okay. Siphonostele abdingadhu stele with pith. There is no leaf gap. What is the meaning of leaf gap? Leaf gap abdingradhu, ipo idhu leaf originated agudhu. Actually this is a petiole region. Okay. So this is a petiole region. Okay, this is your region of node. Actually, this is called by node. The region ke enna peru appadina node nu peru. Where the leaf is originated on the stem, that region is considered as a node. Okay, from the node, that petiole is arised. Okay, so petiole is a stalk of the leaf, isn't it? Petiole is a stalk of the leaf. Okay, this is a stalk of the leaf. So in the base of the petiole we can see the small gap. Okay, so node abdingradhu where the leaf and the petiole arise aagakudiya region ku peru node, but actually that is called the base of the leaf. During in this region we can see a small gap, anga oru chinna oru depression irukum. So that depression is called leaf gaps. Okay, this is your leaf gap. Leaf gap na rendu leaf ku idaila irukka gap nu la solla koodadhu. Okay va. So leaf gap means the base of the petiole, it has a some depression, so that region is called the leaf gaps. Okay va. So the siphonostele, stele with pith, no leaf gap. Appo inga enna illa, leaf gap e irukka. Leaf gap illa na romba tight ah irukku, ipdi arranged ah irukku, arranged ah irukku. Okay va. So what about here in the solenostele? Stele with pith and leaf gap. Okay, அங்க என்ன இருக்கு? பித்து இருக்குது, லீஃப் கேப் இருக்குது. ஓகே, வேர் தேர் இஸ் நோ பித் த புரோட்டோஸ்டீல். ஓகே, வேர் த பித் இஸ் பிரசன்ட், தேர் இஸ் நோ லீஃப் கேப் அப்படின்னா சைபனோஸ்டீல். ஸோ இந்த சொலினோஸ்டீல் தேர் இஸ் யோ ஸ்டீல் வித் பித் அண்ட் லீஃப் கேப். ஓகேவா, ஃபர்ஸ்ட்ல உள்ளத பித்து இல்லை, செகண்ட்ல உள்ளத ஸ்டீல் வித் பித், நோ லீஃப் கேப். ஹியர் த த்ரீஸ் ஆர் பிரசன்ட். ஓகே. So next we have to see one by one what are the types of protostele. The protostele is has a haplostele, actinostele and a plectostele, mixed protostele, mixed protostele with a pith. Okay, haplostele means a central xylem. Okay, it has a central xylem. The xylem is surrounded by a phloem. So this is your xylem. The xylem is surrounded by a phloem. Okay, this is the phloem. Okay, the xylem is surrounded by a phloem, is considered as a haplostele. We cannot see any pith inside. Okay, example for that, Rhynia lycodium. Rhynia lycodium example. Actinostele abdingadhu enna na, it has a star shaped, and eppadi irukona star shaped, that is your xylem. The star shaped xylem is surrounded by a phloem. Okay, that is a lycopodium serratum. And plectostele means xylem as plate. It has a xylem is a plate. This is one xylem, this is another xylem. So all the xylems are surrounded by a phloem. Ipo idha chutti ella enna irukum, phloem irukum. So xylem vandu plate plate ah arranged ah irukum, adukku in between la enna irukuna phloem irukum. Mixed protostele, xylem as a patches in phloem. Okay ma, மிக்சடு புரோட்டோசில் வித் பித்து. இங்கே வந்து என்ன இருக்குன்னா சென்டரில், இந்த சென்டர் ரீஜியனில் ஃபஸ்ட்டு பித்து இருக்கும், தென் xylem, it is a pith and xylem, then it has a phloem. Okay, it is arranged. So that is, we will see the detail. Next, siphonostyle. Siphonostyle is divided into cladosiphonic siphonostyle. Cladosiphonic siphonostyle is a without leaf gap. Ectopholic siphonostyle is phloem external to the xylem. But that is nothing. It's a xylem. Xylem is surrounded by a phloem. Amphiphloic. Amphi. Amphine vandale 2. Yeah. So that is your amphibious. That is a live in water and land. Here amphi means that is a center. We have a xylem. Okay. Then surrounded by a phloem. Then it has a xylem. And again, which is surrounded by a phloem. Okay. It has here two phloem is ring is there. Okay. Rendu time phloem varum. So xylem sutti first or phloem irukum, appuram or phloem irukum. Okay va. So appadi illana ipo idu phloem, idu phloem, inga enna irukku xylem. Idha mattum eduthukalam. Okay. So phloem, xylem, again phloem. Okay. The phloem is surrounded by both region, internal region and external region. Rendu pakkamume surrounded aayirundhathu appadina அது amphiphloic siphonostyle அப்படின்னு சொல்றோம். So what about in the solenostyle அப்படினு பார்த்தோம்னா it has a pith and leaf gaps are present. Okay. Ectophloic solenostyle, amphiphloic solenostyle. Ecto means outer. Actually the xylem is in center and outer the xylem phloem is present. Xylத்துக்கு வெளியில phloem இருக்கும்னு அர்த்தம். Amphiphloic அப்படினா என்ன அர்த்தம்? இதே சேம் தான். So xylem is surrounded by inner and outer. Okay. Xylem is surrounded by the phloem inner and outer. Okay. So dictyostyles அப்படிங்கிறது so small cells the scattered. Okay. The steels are scattered in the phloem. The steels வந்து full அங்கங்க scattered ஆயிருந்தது அது பேர் மெரிஸ்டீல்ஸ் அப்படினு சொல்றோம். So polycyclic. Polyனா என்ன அர்த்தம்? More layer. Cyclic அப்படினா actually it has a more layer of xylem and phloem. Xylem phloem is simultaneously they have to surrounded the phloem. Actually the phloem is surrounded the xylem அப்படினு அர்த்தம். So eustachyl அப்படிங்கிறது so actually all the vascular bundles are around the pith. This is a pith. So the vascular bundles are around the pith. These are all vascular bundles. So all the vascular bundles are around the pith. It's look like a ring. இது வந்து எப்படி இருக்கு? ஒரு ரிங் மாதிரி. பித்தை சுத்தி எல்லா சைலம் எல்லா வாஸ்குலார் பண்டலும் ரிங் மாதிரி ஃபார்ம் ஆச்சு அப்படின்னா அதுக்கு பேர் யூஸ்டீல் அப்படின்னு பேர். ஓகே. So next we have to see one by one. Okay, the first one is a protostyl. Okay. A protostyle phloem is surround the xylem. Okay, what about this? This is here. So this is your phloem. This is phloem. And this is your pericycle actually. And this is xylem. Okay, so here the xylem is surrounded by a phloem. Okay, you cannot see any pith. Okay, in the protostyle the pith is absent. So it consists of so many types already we studied. That is a protostyle. Protostyles are divided into first one is a haplostyle. Okay, the xylem surrounded by the phloem is known as a haplostyle. That is simply that is a protostyle. Protostyle enna sonna xylem is surrounded by a phloem. Adhe da haplostyle. Example for that is a selaginella. Okay va. Appo protostyle haplostyle ku same definition da. Okay, so what is the definition? The xylem is surrounded by a phloem but the pith is absent. Okay. And actinostyle, the star shaped xylem. This is a star shaped xylem. This is a star shaped xylem. Okay, the star shaped xylem is surrounded by a phloem. Okay, so this is a actual slide. Okay, this is a picture that is actual slide. So this xylem is surrounded by a phloem. Actually the xylem the shape is a star shape. Okay, so without pith. So The example, Lycopodium serratum. So what is the example for the actinostyl? Lycopodium serratum. What is the example for the haplostyl? So that is your Selaginella. Okay. So plectostyl. Xylem plates alternate with the phloem plates. Okay. So this is your xylem. This is your xylem. The xylem plate is alternate with the, this is alternate with the phloem. This is your phloem. So that is a plate like structure. Xylem and phloem is alternatively arranged as a plates. Okay, without a pith. That is example Lycopodium clavatum. This is the actual structure. It is a slide of, that is your plectostyles. Plecto means plates. Mixed protostyle. Okay, so xylem groups uniformly scattered on the phloem. Actually, so this is your okay, these are all considered. So this is here, the dot is considered as your xylem. This is your xylem. The xylem is uniformly scattered on the phloem. Okay, phloem is like a sheet. Okay, and the phloem mele the xylem anganga enna panirukom scattered panirukom nu artham. Okay, va? So idhula pathina adhe maari dhaan irukum. So actually idella vandu the region. So this region, this is your xylem. Idellame vandu enadhu appadina xylem. This region is a xylem. So that is a background vandu enadhu appadina, that is your phloem. Okay, phloem abdinga sheet ku mela xylem vandu anganga scattered ana sidari poi irukna artham. That is xylem groups uniformly scattered on the phloem. Abdi correct ah adoda size ella ore maadhiriya uniform skirted irukku. That is example Lycopodium, that is a cernum. Lycopodium cernum. Next one is a siphonostyle. Okay, so second one siphonostyle. So how many styles we studied in the protostyle? Under the protostyle is a haplostyle, actinostyle, plectostyle. Okay, so here siphonostyle. Siphonostyle xylem is surrounded by a phloem with pith, avladha. Okay, anga enna sonnom, xylem is surrounded by a phloem without pith, but here with pith at the center. Where is the pith? The pith is present in the center region. So this is ectophloic siphonostyle. Ecto means outer. Okay, xylathukku outer la phloem irukona artham. So amphiphloic appadina xylathoda outer layum phloem irukum, xylathoda inner region layum phloem irukum. That is amphiphloic siphonostyle. Okay, so what is siphonostyle? That is here with pith is present. There is no gap, leaf gap on the kadayadu, but inga enna present a irukna pith vandu irukudna artham. So that is a solenostyle, eustyle, atactostyle, polycyclic styl. These are all under the siphonostyle. Okay, the first one is a ectophloic siphonostyle. Ecto nu sollum bodhe namakku phloem in outside appdi yabagam varanum. Phloem is restricted only on the external side of the xylem. So the pith is center. Okay, appo idu center la irukk koodiyathu pith. Okay, so what about this one? That is your, so this is your phloem. This phloem and this is xylem. This is xylem. Okay, so pith is in the center. This is covered by or surrounded by a, that is a Xylem, then xylem is surrounded by a phloem. This type of arrangement is called ectophloic siphonostyle. Okay, so this is the actual structure. Actually, this is a pith, and this region is called, that is a xylem, and another one is a phloem. So after the phloem, we can see the pericycle. Next to the pericycle, endodermis. Endodermis next region on the cortex. Then next region on the end of the abdina, epidermis. Okay, va? Idu eduthi vechukom. The first one, this is your epidermis. So this is your epidermis. Okay, and this region is called cortex. And this region is called endodermis. So where is the cortex? The cortex is between the cortex is between the epidermis and endodermis. This is the cortex. Cortex is present between the epidermis and endodermis. Okay. And next layer is called, that is a pericycle. Pericycle. Okay. So where is the pith? The pith is in the center. Okay, so that's what is the stele. The stele consists of the pericycle, vascular bundle. Vascular bundle nu sollum bodhu xylem o phloem o adangirum. So next one is your pith. Okay, so next ectophloic siphonostyle ku appra enna varum? Amphiphloic siphonostyle. Amphiphloic siphonostyle. So amphiphloic na enna, the same structure va adha enna varum? So the both region, the xylem is surrounded external and internal side by the phloem. Okay, so amphiphloic siphonostyle, the phloem is present on both sides of the xylem, the pith is in the center. That is the example marsilia. This is the structure of marsilia. Okay, so this is already I said, that is a epidermis. And this is a cortex region, and next we can see that is your endodermis. The endodermis, so this is phloem in outside, and this another white region is a phloem in. This is outside, this is a phloem in inside. Okay, so we can see the phloem in external and internal. So in between we can see, this is your, that is your xylem region, and center la irukkuri and the black color irukliya, this is a pith. So siphonostyle appadinaale center la vandu pith irukkanum. This black color is a pith. That is surrounded by a xylem, then xylem is surrounded by a phloem in inner and outer region. Okay, so example for that is a marsilia. Next is solenostyle. Okay, so what is the difference between the solenostyle and siphonostyle? In the siphonostyle consists of, that is a pith. Okay, there is no leaf gap, but what about in the solenostyle? They have a pith and leaf gap. It has a pith and leaf trace, that is considered as a leaf gap, is otherwise called leaf trace. Okay, so the stele is perforated at a place or the places corresponding to region of the leaf trace. Ipo namma paathom liya the leaf trace region as onna. So this is your stem, means where the leaf is arranged. So this region, inda edathila irukkudiya inda depressions, so in the depression da enadhu, that is called leaf trace. Okay, so appa solenostyle vandu enga irukku, where the solenostyle is present appadina, which is present in the leaf trace. Kiva, what about in the siphonostyle? That is not present in the leaf trace. Kiva, so this is present in the leaf trace. It has a pith. Okay, so this is your pith is present. Okay, and it has a xylem. The xylem is surrounded by a phloem. Okay, and another layer is called, that is a endodermis. Pericycle, then endodermis. The first layer is epidermis, and second layer is a cortex, and third layer is endodermis. Fourth layer is a pericycle, and fifth layer is, that is a vascular tissue, xylem and phloem, and inner region we can see the pith. Idu da arrangement. In the arrangement la da nama paakom. Next, ectophloic solenostyle. What is ectophloic? Ectophloic means the outer regions of the xylem. We have a phloem. okay va xylitoid outer edge ipo ectopheic solenostrial appdi varumbodhu first center la vandu enna irukna pith next in the region vandu xylem region okay so this is your pith next region is a xylem so next to the xylem we can see the outer phloem okay then pericycle then endodermis then cortex okay what about in the amphiphloic solenostrial okay amphi appadina we can see the so we can see the phloem in both region this is one phloem this is the another one this is the inner phloem this is the outer phloem okay in between we can see that is a xylem idha xylem okay idu vandu ectophloic solenostrial this is the amphiphloic solenostrial so ectophloic means that outer side of the xylem has a phloem only one layer of the phloem is present what about here it has a two layer of the phloem okay so that is present in between the xylem xylathukku outer layer inner layer phloem irukku avladha okay so what is the main difference between the protostyle another one is a siphonostyle and a solenostyle appadina it's a very 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 simple the protostyle has a without that is without pith okay So in the second one, it has a pith and there is no leaf cap. And third one, it has a pith and leaf cap is present. Okay. So ordinary stele means that is a xylem is surrounded by a phloem. So that ectophloic. Abina outer layer of phloem irunda ectophloic. So rendu pakkamum phloem irunda chena adhik peru amphiphloic avladha. Okay. So with the help of the terms, with the help of the heading, we can write the notes easily. You should understand to write. Okay, don't muck up it. The next amphiphloic solenostrial already we studied. That is a real picture. Okay, ma. So amphiphloic liner. This is outer phloem. So this is the inner phloem. Okay, in between we can see the xylem. The pith is in the center and the phloem is present on both side of the xylem. Example: adiantum, pedatum. Adiantum pedatum okay so dictyostyles means that is a stele is separated into several vascular strands actually anga stele vandu enna aguduna each and every one is separated okay vandu the stele vandu ipdi onnu onnu thani thaniya irukku okay kutti kutti stele ah irukku inda kutti kutti stele da nam enna solrana dictyostyles okay each stele we can see the xylem is surrounded by phloem Xylem is surrounded by a phloem. We can see the many steles inside. Okay, that is a dictyostyle. The vascular strands and each one is called a meristyle. Oh, what is the kind of pair? Apni na, it is called by a meristyle. Next is eustyle. So, what is the eustyle? The vascular bundles are forming a ring around the pith. Is called eustyle. This is a pith. Okay. So, these are all the vascular bundles. It is forming a ring around the pith. Is called eustyle. So, this is a characters of dicot stem. Okay. So, attractive steles means the all the steles. Actually, the vascular bundles are scattered on the xylem okay all the vascular bundles scattered in conditions scattered na enna artham ella sedari poi irukku or ring ah form agama sedari poi irukkadukku da enna peru appadina that is known as a atactostyles that is on the cortex cortex region mela appadiye scattered ah irukku so polycyclic stele means it consists of so many layers already we studied that is a xylem is surrounded by so many layers of the phloem okay so that is called by amphiphloic solenostyle In the pteridium, okay. Okay, that's all. Today we studied that is the types of stele, isn't it? And classifications of the pteridophytes, isn't it? So, do you have any doubt? You can raise your question. Okay, keep on watching our YouTube. Okay, you have to give your comments. Thank you so much, children. அப்புறம் தான் கட் பண்ணுவீங்களா இப்போ இது இருப்பாங்களா குடிச்சிட்டீங்களா இப்போ டைம்ல இருக்கு அங்க வந்துட்டேன் அங்க வந்து இப்போ கேட்கலாமா